Pirate Watch. Starting it. Settings. Display sub. Titles. You can mute? I don't know about that. I don't know about mutant. I know about mutants. X-Men. Call them Heckman. So, I really don't hear nothing. General controls, radio zoom, pause, held item, jog, climb, flashlight. All right, let's go. Fire watch. Firestorm. Campo Santo. Boulder, Colorado, 1975. That got some good drink here. You see, Julia. I gotta push a button. Okay. She's about your age, late 20s, laughing with well-dressed professors and grad students from the nearby Colorado U Boulder, or CU Boulder. You, Henry, are out drinking with your pals. You approach her. You are drunk. So what's your, you know, mayor? Ah. Just straight up tell him. You're pretty, she says, coolly. You are not. You are future hangover. What? You reply, confused. What? You reply, confused? Someone should buy you a cheeseburger, she said. She flagged down a waiter, and 1 week later, you are Julia's boyfriend. Okay, let's go. R2 to use objects. Pick up backpack. Get that dust mop. Please don't tell me that's my vehicle. That's my car. And I just throw that in the back trunk like, yo. You date for over a year. She drives you absolutely nuts. It's great. You move in, you share an apartment near the school with a view of the mountains. You two drink beers out on the deck. You drink beer just about anywhere. Life is good. Julia wants to get a dog. There's a scuffy. Julia's in love. She wants to bring it with her to class. There's also an intimidated but gentle-eyed German Shepherd. Nothing bad could happen to Julia while walking this dog. It's badass. Freaking the Shepherd! I'm from the hood! Mayhem's an excellent dog. He loves wrestling with you in the park and goes with Julia on runs. Even though he's too big to bring to school, Julia loves him all the same. Mayhem is a friend, child, and pet all rolled into one. Mayhem. 1979, you walk, you talk, 9:30 p.m. and he still radiates off the high desert. What do you think about kids, she asks. Kids, they're not very smart or good at much. I say if you and I have some, a couple little idiots. I love my little run. We didn't rush. She looked away out toward the mountain. We had plenty of time, right? Speak for yourself, mister. Don't worry, you assure her. You tell her she has the body of an undergrad. My ovaries didn't get the memo, she said, laughing it off. One day, okay. Okay, one day she says. 6 months later, you get engaged, laying in bed on a Sunday morning. Got my trusty, busty backpack. All right. Ranger Joe. Look at that. Fire danger today. Prevent forest fire. You ain't wearing corduroys. Only you can prevent forest fires. All right. So, Daryl Fail, Trailhead. Do not forget to check in. You're in their country. Learn to live with bears. No fireworks. Daryl Fair Trail is not recommended for inexperienced hikers. Daryl Fair is a primitive backcountry trail. Alright. It's Thursday night and Julia is 4 hours late. She doesn't call and you worry and get angrier by the minute. She walks in after you've gone to bed. But she's clearly been having a fun time. You fight when she gets between the sheets. You ignore her. You don't touch each other all night. The next day you feel guilty for being so angry and ask her about her evening. She said it was great. You hold onto a tiny pill of resentment. You make some coffee and go to work. Julia still likes to draw. She draws plants for her research. She draws all the places you go. She draws you. Pose like He-Man, son. By the powers of Grayskull, I have the power. This game looked really gorgeous. Very amazing. I like how it's looking. Very gorgeous game. Completely different from what I've been playing lately. Very good. Two Forks Lookout Tower. 8 more miles still. Push X. Hop over that bitch. Crisscross to make you jump. Look at that. That shit looks dope. During the summer, you and Julia enjoy walking mayhem at night. There's a festival in town. It brings in folks from far away places. One of them tries to mug you with a knife. My may move fuck the dog. Julia yells. She gets flustered and has trouble speaking when she's stressed. You confront the attacker. Beat the brakes. Your arm get cut up, but you beat the guy to a pulp. You don't feel very tough. You cry your eyes out before the cops show up. Julia asks to take a different path from that day forward. You say okay. You don't want to go that way either. From then on, you walk by the river. Plan 1984. Plans to have kids get waylaid by work. Julia gets offered a job at Yale. Yale is in Connecticut, 2,000 miles away. It's a great job, associate department chair. She wants to move. You absolutely do not. Don't never take. No, you never let nobody not take their dreams. Chase your dreams. That's the number one thing. If a person get an opportunity to dream, you let them chase their dream. Because if it's meant to be, they'll be there. You don't want to be the person that holds them back. Let them go for it. Give them full support. You try to tell them no, you was dumb as fuck. You ask her if she commute back and forth. You don't want to move to Connecticut. She said that'll be hard, but she'll do it if you won't move. You tell her not to pass it up if it was what she wants. She agrees. She flies back to Boulder 3 times each semester. Julia is sent home from Yale on paid leave that they're having an episode. She lost it on a colleague for borrowing books that were important to her research. She didn't remember she had happily loaned them to him just 2 days prior. She was found crying in the stairway. You say that maybe you guys should talk to someone about it? You make macaroni and cheese, drink wine, and try. Yeah. It works. You watch Dallas on TV and sleep together. Dallas, this is the 80s. Wow. Good old JR. Pick up the journal. He-Man. Damn, I was trying to read that. Mayhem is getting older. He got silver hair down his back and slows down at night. You and Julia walk into the bar to see your friends, and it feels like nothing has changed. Julia go back to the university. Julia's affection gets worse. She can't remember things in class. Her research is in shambles. She drives her car to the next town over for a particular reason and has to be brought home by the police. She is sent home on permanent medical leave. Someday you get Julia, Some days you get the Julia who calls you a dope and your unborn child's little idiots. Other days you get a stranger. She pulls you into the bedroom to make love. After 5 minutes, she goes into a panic, believing her dad is at the door. You tell her family, they get crushed and begin to make trips to and from their home in Australia to visit her. For a while, your friends come by with little things to brighten the day. She gets worse. What's up, Power Up? You spend your days following the house. You count the seconds between the two weekly visits from Daniel, the nurse. He suggests that Julia could live somewhere else, somewhere with 24-hour care, a home. It sits with you for a couple of months. Man, be determined to take her home. Yeah, you take care of her at the house. You don't put nobody in a home. Alright, now let's get this walk on. Okay, let's look at this game. This game is gorgeous. Look at that. Look at all that. The trees, the color. Just amazing. Oh, look at that. Big buck. Look at that. That's a 10-foot buck. It's a 10-point buck right there, son. It's impossibly hard. The worst is when you get mad at her, like when she tried to cook her own food. You can't do anything without her, and she can't do anything without you. When she goes to sleep, you stay up for a few hours, drinking on deck, watching baseball in the summer, college basketball in the winter, and drinking then too. You start going out after you put her to bed. The first time you do it, you worry about her getting up and walking around while you're gone. Oh, trust you sleep like a rock. You go to the same bar at the Bourne in the Pearl Street. It's nice there. Over time, you tell Sheila, the bartender, everything. It's a huge weight off. At 1 a.m. a couple nights a week. We look forward to those nights. One night, you were stopped at the DUI checkpoint. You blow a .1 and taken to jail for the night. You consider trying to hide it, but you tell your sister-in-law. Thanks, Power Up. Julia's parents take the next plane from Australia. They can't believe the state your house is in. They tell Julia to come to live with them. You don't argue. You say you'll visit soon. A few weeks go by. Summer's coming and you see an ad in the paper for a job. You take it.